like to thank you all for coming out to be here with our families. We've seen so many people that have been such a huge part of our lives since my mom and the military brought us here in 1985. You all, for one shape or another, have become a family. I truly appreciate you. My dad's loss was very unexpected. I was actually in California at NTC. My colonel came in his vehicle speeding up, and it's funny, Keith and I saw the commander coming on the Blue Force tracker. We're thinking tactical, we're thinking, man, you know, somebody must not have got word to the boss that we were going to be out here. Keith kept the guys moving. I said, I'll go, you know, and engage the boss. So I walked up to talk to him. Colonel had a very solemn look on his face. And I'm thinking, man, I said, what's happened? And then I see the chaplain get out of the back of his vehicle. And I'm thinking, which one of my soldiers, Lord, am I about to have to give bad news to? And that's when the colonel put his hand on my shoulder and told me, Lord, I'm sorry to let you know that your father passed away yesterday. I can't begin to tell you the amount of emotion that we've gone through the last couple of weeks. But what I can tell you is that the strength of my family never ceases to amaze me. The music that you heard right before this service, we've been laughing about it. It wasn't funny back then. There was nothing, but those were my Saturday mornings. Nothing but chores. Corey and Doc and them, they didn't want to spend the night because they knew they'd be doing chores. Yeah, I love them for it. It's amazing what turns out to be some of the fondest memories of your life. Moving to Hawaii, I was in Korea right before this, and I was originally going to be going to Germany. I was excited about Germany. God had a different plan in mind, and it turned out to be the best thing that could have possibly happened. I've got a beautiful fiance, but more importantly, or as important today, is these past 2 years were the closest I've ever been with my father. They gave us so much time where I saw him through different eyes. I never really understood my father until I put the uniform on, and then I realized, this man's not crazy. he simply spent a lifetime dedicating himself to the service of the country. All the mornings that we got grounded for not eating total whole wheat cereal. The morning, bed not being perfectly made. Corey and I'm like, why? Dude, why can't you come to the course? I'm like, I'm grounded for a week. I didn't eat my cereal this morning. You're exaggerating, but this is our life. My dad accomplished a lot during his time on Earth. And he'd be the first to tell you, as my sister said, he wasn't a perfect man. We're not a perfect family. But one of the things that he was the most proud of was the family that he put together. For those of you that don't know, my father grew up in a foster care system. So one of the biggest desires of his heart was to have a family. He never fully got to experience it. And for all of the people that are here from the City of Refuge, if you've never sat and had that discussion with him, it was largely why the man of faith that you knew. Some of my favorite father-son chats were about what pushed him to God and his desire and need, because he didn't have that father example. He didn't know what it was like to be a good husband. So he found that strength, he found that guidance in God, and it was a work in progress. But one of the hardest working men I've ever known. Grateful the positive life lessons he taught me that I'm going to carry on in my own family life. And equally as grateful for the candor he shared with me for his flaws and his mistakes so that I wouldn't carry it into my family life. Granny, I think that was one of my favorite things about you and Dad's dynamic was that he never considered you a mother-in-law. You know, you always hear on TV people complaining about, oh, my mother-in-law. You know, believe it or not, that was never once the dynamic with my father and my grandmother. He took great pride in feeling that he had a second chance of having a mother. You know, I'm very fortunate. I look forward to that in my own life. Mom. Wow. Mom, I wish there was something I could say to take away the hurt. I really do. What I will tell you is that Dad's legacy is fully grounded in you. You're the foundation of everything that was positive in his life and everything that came from his life. All the lives that were touched in here, it all is because you believed in him. It was because you continued to persevere with him. Almost 4 decades of loving each other, grooming each other, struggling with each other. 2 full military careers and a 5th child on his way to college. That's not luck. You know, that's deliberate. And it's a labor of love from you and Dad pouring yourselves into us. And we didn't think you had anymore. You know, your family will forever be grateful. Shay, my beautiful sister. I did not think you were going to survive that picnic. I tell you, you and Dad, some of my favorite stories in the world have seen the growth that you and Dad had. It brought him so much joy to see the woman that you became, to see the mother you became, those beautiful babies right there in Zell and Jada. He was such a proud grandfather. Even though I was moving slowly, he at least knew grandkids were on the way. And the best is going to come, I promise you that. We leash it and we make sure you pass the word back to Sarah in Washington, okay? Dad and I, since I've been back, we've had so many lunches, just laughing and smiling and talking about you guys. Shopping for the house, you know, when I bought it, we talked about how it would be you and Sarah, you know, doing the swimming. Fiercely intelligent, you know, he was so impressed with the head that he grows out on your shoulders. I used to love seeing him smile and his voice just fade off, you know, while he would speak about you and Sarah. I can't feel the void of a father, but on that road, in the back, Keith's back there, you've got brothers that are all around you, that'll do anything for you, right, and I promise you'll never walk for anything. EJ. I tell you what, EJ, such a blessing, and we're so proud of you, bro, and Dad found so much pride in seeing the man you became from time you were a little boy, he and I used to joke that he would not be able to stop working out until you were out the house. He knew you were, he knew you were gonna be big. I tell you to stand at an angle when I'm walking around you. Now you're taller than me and you just graduated from high school. You know, don't get any crazy fellas. The family has so much to thank you for because of how much time we spent together simply supporting you in your senior year. You know, I've been out of the country for the majority of my military career, so it was a huge reward to be here to watch you become the best basketball players in the state. You know, it's fun watching you get courted by these coaches now and move on to the next step. But don't ever forget that Dad was immensely proud of me. I don't remember him coming to my games. It was an ugly jump shot. If you never fully grasped it, you know, just know how much that meant that no matter how busy the family was, where we were at, if we were on the island, you know, the family was there to watch you play. I'm going to be forever grateful to you for that. Dad lives on through us and on this road in Sarah, Washington. Is his legacy, you know. So, as Elder Gadsden said, it's been the theme of this memorial. You know, continue to celebrate Dad. You know, continue to look forward to making him proud the same way you have, the same way we have, while he was here. And it's just one more motivator. We wish he was here, but we're going to be fine, and we're going to be stronger as a family for it. We truly appreciate all of you coming out to celebrate with us. It means a lot to us. I know it means a lot to my father, and you all a lot to him, whatever your respective relationships were. We will forever love and respect.